Guard the bridge. Hold your ground. Keep the field. Stand watch. Do deeds of daring. Do acts of valor. Do that which is worthy to be recorded in the annals. Through God, the Bible says, we shall do valiantly. Exodus 53 says, our God is a warrior. He's not only a God who fights for us, yes, the battle is the Lord's, but he also fights through us. The Bible says we endure hardship as good soldiers, so we will check the progress of the enemy. We will guard the bridge. We will stand our ground. We will not give up an inch. We will not throw in the white towel. We're not going to hoist the white flag of surrender, because giving up is not in our vocabulary. We are those who say, I will guard the gate at all costs. Stand your ground and don't give up an inch. We are going to check the progress of the enemy. That's got to be our mindset. We're warriors. Our generation, we get too soft. We're done with that soft stuff. We're going to stand our ground. We're going to hold our ground. Horatius Sockley's been reading his story today. He lived 2,500 years ago. He was living in the late 6th century BC. I mean, we're talking about a long time ago, 2,500 years ago, 2.5 millennia ago. Now, Horatius Sockley's, he's known for defending the Pons Sublicius, which is the earliest known bridge of ancient Rome. Now, this gave access to the northern part of the city, and it spanned over the Tiber River. Now, when the Etruscan army was attacking Rome, Horatius Sockley's, with two of his companions, stood their ground to guard the gate against the oncoming onslaught of the Etruscan army. Well, two of his companions fled because it was too scary, but Horatius Sockley's stood all by himself, kind of like Ganner from the book Traitor. He said, I don't care if you come at me one by one or all at once. I don't care at all. So he let them come to him. Well, sure enough, he told his friends in the Roman army, you guys cut down the bridge. You guys cut down the Pons Sublicius so the Etruscan army can't enter the city from the north, and I will stand and check their progress and ward them off while you cut down the bridge. Well, sure enough, he was able to successfully defend the entrance to the city by guarding the gate all by himself against the entire Etruscan army, Horatius Sockley's, defending the Pons Sublicius until it was cut down so they were not able to enter. He checked the progress of the enemy. He himself received many wounds, just like Alexander the Great received many wounds on his body, 9 to be exact, except on his back. He said that during one of the greatest speeches of all time when his soldiers were departing from him and leaving him and mutinying him in India, and he said, I have wounds on my body, but not on my back, because I never run. Well, that was Horatius Sockley's. He receives wounds on his body. He checks the progress of the enemy, because Polybius says that he cared more about the glory that would go to his future reputation than he did about extending his lifespan. So after he defeated this oncoming army, checking their progress, he jumped into the Tiber River, and one historian says he lost his life. Another said he swam to the shore. Scholars debate on that, but be that as it may, it says that the enemy, history tells us, Polybius tells us, the enemy was more scared of the audacity with which he held his ground, his endurance, his courage, and his confidence binding upon the victory than they were scared of his strength or his physical muscle. Because listen, bravery is stronger than muscle. Bravery is stronger than muscle. It's not about how much muscle you have. It's not about how much weight or girth you have behind you when it comes to the institution. It's a matter of how brave are you? How courageous are you? With what courage? With what confidence? With what endurance? With what audacity will you guard the gate? It's not about, oh, how much support do I have from the institution? It's not about, oh, how much is the establishment throwing their weight behind me? It's not, oh, how much are these influencers saying my name? It's, how courageous am I? Because how courageous are you? That is what determines whether in 2,500 years, people will remember, like Horatius Sockley's, your great deeds of daring. Guard the gate. Remember, courage, bravery is more powerful even than muscle. Guard the gate. Stand your ground. Surrender is not in your vocabulary. As Napoleon Bonaparte said, impossible is not a word in my vocabulary. He said specifically, impossible is a word found only in the dictionary of fools. Like Horatius Sockley's, let's stand our ground, let's guard the gate, and let's do things that will live on far beyond our lifespan.